Well, finally arrived from Perfect Circuit Audio in California. EVENTIDE Space Reverb. Let's open up the box. Because of Black Friday and Cyber Monday, etc. And it may, the driver even said, the FedEx driver said it may have been put on the wrong truck because it went from Kansas to Chillicothe, Illinois, then to Bourbonnais, Illinois, and then to Champaign, Illinois, and then to Morton, Illinois, and then to Peoria, Illinois. She said it sounds like it got put on the wrong truck, but that's okay. All is forgiven. Oh, we got the bubble wrap. We got large peanuts. We've got Perfect Circuit stickers. They're no longer called Perfect Circuit Audio. They're called Perfect Circuit. You know, everybody's changing their names nowadays. Dunkin' Donuts is Dunkin', and Race for the Cure is now More Than Pink, and et cetera. Radio Shack changed their name to The Shack, and then they went bankrupt. But anyhow, here we go. This is Space. Man, that's more peanuts than I've ever seen in a package. That's a lot of styrofoam peanuts. Packaging peanuts there. You could feed a styrofoam elephant or monkey or something, all those peanuts. But okay, we got it. We're going to look at it now. Nice, and I love it when a device comes in a box. This is a sleeve on the box, but still, that's nice, nicely designed and informative. And you know, if you saw this in your Guitar Center or Sam Ash or Sweetwater store or something, and you say, well, let me look at this EVENTIDE Space, and you could pick up the box and you could look at the information that's on it and maybe learn a little bit about the device. And the people that work at the store selling musical instruments, they could read and learn a few things about the devices they're selling. Usually, they don't know very much, but they just sell them, they don't spell them. So I'm gonna take the sleeve off, and even with the sleeve off, it's still very cool packaging. I mean, they're calling it a stomp box, but I'm not gonna be stomping it. That's for the guitar players, you know how they are. And kind of rough, but there it is. And let's see if I'm smart enough to know how to open it. Yeah, I am kind of smart. There we go. There it is. Okay, now we got a product catalog. Now, this to me makes a lot of sense to have a product catalog, because if you bought one product, chances are, if you are satisfied with the product, you might want to know, well, what else does this company make? Now, EVENTIDE, they're showing their EVENTIDE audio products, but I'd like to see their audio, I mean, the EVENTIDE avionics products, because they also make avionics, aviation equipment. Of course, why would I need to know about that? Because I don't pilot a plane, or I don't operate a airport or anything like that, so I guess it's just as well. Now there's a big fat instruction user manual. That's I wonder if it's all English. It's all English. That's even better. Look at that thing. That's the user manual. And I don't have to print one out and spend my paper and toner on a manual. It looks like, and it's more than a quick start, it looks like a very comprehensive manual with diagrams and all kinds of interesting things in it, and showing you how to hook it up and what you can do with it, and foot switches, and boy. Looks like a, I wonder if there's a list, a whole bunch of MIDI things, software updates, and We got, I wish there was a list of presets. Yeah, well, here we go. My wish is granted. Algorithms and presets. That's pretty neat because it's got 100 presets, and most of them, I think about 80 are artists who have worked with Nine Inch Nails and Living Color and lots of really, you know, good bands, famous, popular bands. And so, yeah, they are listing the algorithms, at least the algorithms anyhow, and some of the presets, I think. Not really that many presets, really, though. It's only showing, like, the 12 algorithms. And I don't, and it shows, you know, how the, what the knobs do for each algorithm. But it's not really showing the 100 presets. That's okay, because I know about that. Maybe it's in here. Preset guide. Well, now, see? Just about to complain, or at least mention that there were not the presets in there, and here's a preset guide. And this is exactly what you want. This is showing Divine, Richard Divine, Flood, Vernon Reed, all these amazing guys, John Z and Alex, John Agnello, all the different guys that, and gals, I guess they're mostly men, but all these people who created presets. And you know, some people make fun of presets, but that's, you're paying for them. I mean, you might as well use them. I think you should probably tweak them in some cases, but why not use presets? Because you pay for them. That's part of the price of the device. And then of course there's the quick reference guide in here, a quick reference guide, so you can like quickly get going. And there's a quick reference guide to the algorithms, a graphic depiction of the 12 reverb algorithms, and more packaging protecting the device. See that? Just snug in there with all kinds of foam protection. There's even a silica package to keep moisture from damaging the circuits. And wow, I'm trying to get in here and get this thing. There we go. So isn't that nice? That's pretty cool. A really nice box. I always save the boxes and the packaging just in case I have to return it for some reason. Like, hopefully not, but never want to get rid of your packaging. Now we're gonna, boy, they've got this, so moisture and vibrations and dropping, and nothing's gonna hurt it. It's very well protected, and this is a good high quality company that Space Reverb is known. Space Reverb is very popular, and EVENTIDE is known as a high quality professional effects manufacturer. And they make the rack units, and then they start coming out with what they call pedals, and they're just get critically acclaimed and professionally reviewed with very high marks. So this is the EVENTIDE Space. I'm a proud owner of this new reverb unit, and I look forward to using it. I'll use it today. I'll do a jam. I haven't jammed for 2 days because I've been waiting for this to come, and I didn't want to do any studio jamming because I'm pretty loud and I would possibly not hear the FedEx lady knock at the door. So I haven't been able to do any studio jams. That's okay, take a couple days off. I usually do it every day unless I'm sick or busy or something, but just about every day. Now I know that Stockhausen said that he worked something 8 to 10 hours a day in the studio every day. Prince worked practically 20 hours a day in the studio, from what I recall. A lot of great musicians and composers spent huge amounts of time in the studio every day, and they were just obsessed with it, and so therefore they have like tons. When they die, there are tons of tapes and recordings and digital audio of things they did that have never been commercially made available to the public. It's just sitting in boxes. Jimi Hendrix, I guess some guy in Jamaica has tons of his stuff. And I understand that toward the end of his life, Jimi Hendrix engaged in just wild Merzbow-type noise jams with his guitar in little dives. And I'd love to hear that. Just turn on the, not playing the guitar, but playing the amplifier. And he kind of invented that in a large degree, playing the amplifier and using the electric guitar as a controller for the amplifier and going through the different wah pedals and fuzz tones and distortion and so forth, and playing the guitar as an alien entity and not so much strumming like a normal guitar player. So I'd like to hear him just jamming and feedbacking and just making pure noise and not even caring about melody or rhythm or note-based Western music theory aesthetics. That'd be cool. So this is it, the Eventide Space, and it's just beautiful looking. And I think it really is the gold standard as far as pedals. I'm sure that I know there are rack units by Eventide and others that are even better than this, but they're costing $1,000, $2,000, $5,000, $10,000, whatever dollars. So for I got this in a Black Friday special discount. It normally is never on sale, and it normally regularly sells for $499, $500, and I got it $100 off. It only cost me $399 through Perfect Circuit Audio out there in California. I buy a lot of gear from Perfect Circuit Audio, and they treat me really good. I've returned a few things that were defective or just not satisfying, and they've treated me well. So highly recommend them. And that concludes the unboxing of the Eventide Space Reverb. Thanks for watching.